Gentino Chronicles. New Gentino Chronicles. New Gentino Chronicles. New Gentino Chronicles.
Hey guys, Drew here. So last night I saw The Suicide Squad, James Gunn's film, and I really loved it. I just had a lot of fun. It's, you know, totally gory. It's totally messed up, and it's kind of the crazy violence and disturbing stuff that's in Super. Not quite as disturbing as Super, but it's sort of that darkness mixed with the fun lightness and energy of Guardians of the Galaxy. So I thought that was a really interesting combo. I liked the soundtrack. I thought it's more diverse than like the Guardian soundtrack. Like, he's trying to do something more different. It is kind of, again, akin to Super, I think, in the choices he made. There's, you know, like 90s stuff and just a whole bunch of different things in there. But I had a lot of fun with it. I thought Margot Robbie was great as always. I thought Idris Elba did a really good job. I actually really like John Cena as Peacemaker, and I'm not really a John Cena fan, but I did think he did a good job. And I liked what he did with it. I thought right from the beginning of it, I was pretty surprised at where it went. And I just threw out, like, it had a captivating story. It emotionally hooked me in towards the end. I got pretty emotional, surprisingly. And obviously, I had a lot of fun with King Shark. He was great. Sylvester Stallone voiced him. And that was obviously one of my favorite parts of the movie. Polka Dot Man also was great. There was a very interesting thing with his mom that was pretty hilarious. But, honestly, it's a 5 out of 5 for me. I think what it set out to do, it does perfectly. It's emotional. It's fun. It has an interesting story. It's very comic booky. It's sort of kind of, he's inspired. I mean, I've heard James Gunn talk about this in interviews. He's inspired by kind of like the dime store, like, comics you would see back in the old days. Like, you'd pick up these, like, really silly comic books, and it would have characters like Polka Dot Man and Starro, and just these weird, ridiculous characters, and that's what he's paying tribute to. But while he brings that energy to it, and he brings that weird wackiness to it, he also makes it very artful and very interesting and very cinematic. And I just had a blast with it. It's a 5 out of 5 for me, and I'm looking forward to watching it again. But anyway, I just wanted to show you this real quick. At AMC last night, they gave us an exclusive comic, The Suicide Squad, and a very strange illustration here of Harley Quinn. But I was flipping through it, and it's actually kind of cool. Kind of made me want to start collecting comics. Got some great art here. I have an advertisement for The Suicide Squad, Get Joker. Also, an advertisement for Superman 78 comic book version of the 78 film, and let's see, and Batman 89. So actually some cool stuff from DC Comics. But I was looking through it, and I thought it was actually kind of a cool comic book. But anyway, just wanted to show that. But yeah, I had a lot of fun last night. I would definitely recommend seeing The Suicide Squad. That's on HBO Max if you can't go to the theater. And loved it. But that's about it for today, guys. I'll see you tomorrow.